locked inside the luggage compartment of a Peter Pan bus driving down the highway in Connecticut.
I have a female locked in the underside of a Peter Pan bus. The caller states that she had gotten underneath the bus to get something, and the driver locked her in, and it's en route to Boston. All she can tell me is it's a Peter Pan bus, and the bus was still moving.
The bus had departed New York. Police were able to track the 911 call and pinpoint the bus's location on Interstate 84 in Union, Connecticut, near the Massachusetts border. After pulling the bus over, they say they found the woman in the cargo hold, and she claimed the female bus driver had locked her inside while she was trying to retrieve items from her bag. Caroline Van Allen says she was on the bus and saw a woman on the ground after police pulled them over.
There was a man in a pink shirt, for example. He came up and he said, yeah, I heard banging underneath my feet, like repeatedly. We couldn't wrap our minds around it.
She says she recognized the woman had gotten on the bus with them in New York and says the bus had made only one stop in Hartford. It's unclear exactly how long the woman was locked inside the cargo hold. The driver, 49-year-old Wendy Alberti of Brooklyn, has been arrested and charged with reckless endangerment and unlawful restraint.
And the woman who was locked inside the luggage compartment is okay. That driver was held on a $2,000 bond and has been suspended from her job pending the investigation.
A millionaire murder suspect is back in custody after 4 years on the run. Southern California real estate investor Peter Chatwick has been captured in Mexico. He's accused of killing his wife in 2012. Police say he fled in 2015 after emptying his bank accounts. Investigators say he read books about how to live off the grid.
Siegfried and Roy are speaking out about that tiger attack that ended their Las Vegas show. A tiger named Manticore dragged Roy by the neck in 2003, nearly killing him. The duo have always insisted it was a tragic mistake, saying that Roy had a stroke, prompting the 700-pound tiger to lunge while trying to help Roy. During an exclusive interview with ABC's Deborah Roberts, Siegfried disputes Manticore's trainer, who recently claimed that Roy was to blame for the attack.
Chris Lawrence has come forward now saying that Roy had not been paying as much attention to the tiger, that he changed the routine that night, that it threw him off, and that Roy essentially was to blame. Was he?
I told you, Roy passed out. He had a stroke in reality. How he can change the routine? He noticed that he even was not on stage. He was backstage.
And you can hear much more of Denver's interview coming up on Good Morning America.
In sports, another foul ball has left a baseball fan bloodied and in the hospital. A woman at the Tigers-Rangers game was hit in the forehead. She was sitting along the right field line, which is not protected by netting. The Rangers plan to extend their net next season.
Oh, it was a much happier ballpark moment as Miami's Eason Diaz made his big league debut against the Mets. So his parents were being interviewed in the stands, and then this happened. Proud Papa, his son's first major league hit was a home run off Cy Young winner Jacob DeGrom. Once he stopped yelling, Dad called the moment unreal. Must have been so excited.
Love that. Up next in the polls, the new donut flavor getting lots of attention.
Also ahead, staying cool in the dog days of summer. Why a fan? Maybe a poor choice.
Plus the football superstar and the bike ride that did not go as planned.